Hello, I'm Chandan Lahiri. Today, we're going to see how to make an improvised stretcher using stuff that you find around you or in your backpack. You have a mate who's possibly wounded or sick and can't walk, so he or she needs to be carried. You need a stretcher. Where will you find a stretcher here? There are no paramedics. There are no ambulances. We need to make do with what you find in the area around you and in your backpack. To build a stretcher, essentially, you need two things. You need a couple of poles, and you need something to wrap around the poles, which will make the stretcher. A jacket is a good idea. A jacket is something you'll find in a backpack, or maybe on your back. The poles are a little more difficult, so what you could do is possibly take a walk around the woods around you. You can find fallen branches. You can possibly cut it off trees. You need something which is at least as thick as your wrist, because you don't want it to bend when you're carrying a person. Bamboo is good. So look around you, find two poles, make sure at least it's about 5 feet in length. That'll make an ideal stretcher. Let's go find some bamboo. We've got ourselves a pole. Now to find a second one. I'm sure we'll find it. Prerna's at the job. We have Prerna here, who's found a couple of pieces of bamboo. This one, both of them actually, are about 6 feet tall. So what we have done is just laid these two pieces of bamboo on the ground, parallel to each other. Make sure it's about 1.5 feet apart from each other. The distance doesn't really matter, because now we need to start building the stretcher. Like I said, a jacket is a good idea, and you can find one right on your back. So we'll use this one. I'll take my jacket off, and Prerna is going to make the stretcher. Prerna, why don't you lay it flat on the ground, the other way around. Maybe this way. And put the pole inside the arms. Great. And we'll lay it back again and zip the jacket up. You need as much support that can be distributed as evenly as possible throughout the jacket and the poles. So we have one jacket. This is about 2.5-3 feet tall. Obviously, a grown-up adult is way longer than that. So we'll need a second one. Since I'm not wearing a second one, we'll look into our rucksack and dig one out. And we'll do the same thing. Lay it flat on the ground and put the two poles through the arms and zip it up. Okay, we've got an improvised stretcher ready, but what we need to remember is the heaviest part of a person's body is around the buttocks, and that's where the two jackets are meeting. So we don't want the person slipping out from between two jackets, so ensure there's a bit of overlap between the two jackets. So we've got a stretcher ready. Prerna, if you can pick that up. So we've got a stretcher ready where a person can lie down. We'll make this a little bit stronger. What we'll do is, since we are camping, we have a camping equipment. So we'll take a sleeping mat out and put it on top of this. We'll just do that. Okay, we have the mat, which we use to sleep on. Today we'll use it to strengthen our stretcher. So we'll open it up and lay it out on this. The reason being simple, the weight of the person lying on the stretcher gets distributed also across this. So we'll lay it out and hopefully it won't bend. Yeah, we'll put it the other way around. Okay, here we go. And that's okay. And we have our stretcher ready. And now we need the patient. This is a demo, so I've requested my friend Noel to be the patient. Noel, joining us, being the patient? I only hope you don't topple off, fall off, and it doesn't disintegrate. What we can also do to make the patient a little more comfortable If you have something to put over him, that's good. You might have something like a bum bag. You can put it under his head and turn it into a pillow, so it's slightly more comfortable. And now we'll take the patient out and head for the roadhead. Hopefully there's going to be some car going back, which will help us take him back to a medical facility. Here goes. So that's the way we make an improvised stretcher and take the patient who's unable to walk and get them to a medical facility close by. We'll see you next time with a lot more stuff to learn. Till then, cheers.